Dear students, today we are going to do the explanation of lesson number 24, Understanding Words. Dear students, as we all know that there are different kinds of words which we use while having conversation with someone or the other. We use different kinds of words, but it is really essential that we know that what kind of words we are using and what kind a word should be used. We need to learn that the different kinds of words which will be used in our day-to-day conversation and day-to-day use. Today we are going to do the explanation of homophones, synonyms, antonyms, compound nouns. Dear students, these four types are the types of words which we use while having conversation with someone or the other. Dear students, today we are going to study about homophones first. What are homophones? Homophones are words which have same pronunciation but different spelling and meaning. Here it's being said that homophones are the words which sound alike. The words which sound alike, but they have different meanings and different spellings, those words are known as homophones. For example, hair, H-A-R-E, hair. Dear students, what you all must have read about this hair in your gender topic. In that gender topic, you all must have noticed that hair is the mane of a rabbit. And H-A-I-R, hair. What is hair? Hair is a strand, thin strand, which grows on a human head or other different body parts. Next, D-L-E, idle. This word idle means a person who is not having any work or am sitting without work. I-D-O-L, idle, this also sounds alike. Both these words sound alike, but they have different spellings, as you can see, and they have different meanings. I-D-O-L, idle, means a statue which is used by different peoples as god. And I-D-O-L, idle, can also be used as a word which resembles to the people who are admired by someone. For example, if I like cricketers most, and my favorite cricketer is Rahul Dravid, and I want to be like him, then he will be my idol. Our next topic is synonyms. Dear students, what are synonyms? Synonyms are the words that have the same meaning. As we have read in the previous topic, that homophones are the words which have different spellings and different meanings, but they have the same pronunciation. In this case, in this topic, synonyms, we are talking about different words. We are talking about the words which have different spellings and different pronunciation, but have the same meaning. The words which have the same meaning, but have different spellings and different pronunciations, are known as synonyms. For example, brave. Brave means a person who does not have fear. The other word for brave can be fearless. Second example is sad. Sad means a person who is not happy. We can also use the word unhappy in place of sad, because both these words have same meanings. Our next example is kind. Kind means a person who has good nature. What we can use in place of kind? We can use good-natured. Now we are going to discuss another topic, that is antonyms. Dear students, as we have discussed about synonyms, synonyms are the words which have different spellings, different pronunciations, but have same meaning. The words which have same meanings but different spellings and different pronunciations are called synonyms. But opposite to that, antonyms are the words that mean antonyms are the words that means the opposite of each other. For example, above. What is the opposite of above? Opposite of above is below. Our next example is push. What is the opposite of push? Yes, it's pull. Opposite of push is pull. Our next example is early. What is the opposite of early? Opposite of early is late. Our next topic is compound nouns. Dear students, compound nouns are the words which are formed by joining two nouns. Here, it's been told in this definition that compound nouns are the nouns which are formed by joining two words, two different nouns. When we join two different nouns, we get another noun which resembles to the third object. Now, here are the examples for it. Example number one, book plus case. Dear students, as you can see that book and case both are nouns. When we join both these nouns, we get another noun. We join two different nouns to get the third noun. Like book plus case, it will become book case. What is book case? A case which is used for keeping books. Basket plus ball. What is the meaning of basket plus ball? If we join both these words, we will get basketball. It's a kind of a game which is played by us, isn't it? Now the third example is moon plus light. We all know that moon is a noun and light is also a noun. When we join both these nouns, we get the third noun which is called moonlight. Now if we are getting moonlight, what is the meaning of moonlight? Moonlight means the light which is coming from moon. Dear students, there is an additional topic given in your books that is incorrect omissions. Dear students, there are some cases when we forget to add for, to, at, and of to certain verbs. This is here, it's being told that there are certain cases, there are certain conditions in during which we forget to use for, to, at, and of with the verbs. Here in this topic, we will learn about these incorrect omissions. Firstly, we will learn about for. If, for example, we should ask help. Dear students, as you can see, in these sentences, in these examples, for is incorrectly omitted. And that's why these sentences are wrong. Right now, this first sentence is wrong because we have not used for in this sentence. We have forgotten to use for before the verb. Now we will read second sentence. He is searching the key. Here also in this sentence we have forgotten to use for. So this sentence is also wrong. Third example, she will pay the bus ride. Here also the same condition is given. We have incorrectly omitted for from this sentence. So this sentence is also wrong. Now what we have to do? We have to insert for in proper position so that these sentences can become correct. We should ask. Here we have to use for. For will be used before the noun help. Now this sentence, as you can see, that this sentence is not sounding awkward anymore, and its meaning has become clear to us. So now the sentence is correct. Now we will discuss about second sentence. He is searching the key. In this sentence, we have to insert for in proper position. What we will do? We will insert for before the object, or we can say before the noun. If we will place for before the key, the sentence will become correct. He is searching for the key. Now the sentence has become correct. Example number 3. She will pay the bus ride. Here also we will insert for before the noun. She will pay for the bus ride. Now the sentence is not sounding awkward anymore and the meaning is also clear. So now the sentence is correct. Now we will discuss about the incorrect omission of. First example is, he dreams having a new bicycle. Dear students, as you can see, the sentence is sounding awkward. So this sentence is wrong. And you can also notice that the word of is omitted from here. The word of is not being used in this sentence. Example number 2. She will think a good song to sing at the concert. This sentence, in this sentence also, the word of is being omitted. So this sentence is also sounding awkward. So this sentence is wrong. Dear students, as you as I have explained you that there are some cases in which we forget to put the words like for, at, of, and to the certain verbs. Here, the verb dreams, and when we are using the verb dreams, we have to use the word of, but we have forgotten to use it over here, so that's why it is sounding incorrect. Now what we will do, we will insert of in the correct place. He dreams of having. What does he dream? He dreams of having. Of having what? A new bicycle. Now the sentence has become correct. Our next example is, she will think. What she will think? Here also, we have forgotten to use the word of before or after. Wherever it is, it has got a proper position. We have forgotten to use of with the verb. So I am inserting of at the correct position here. She will think of a good song to sing at the concert. Now this sentence has also become correct. Now we will discuss about at. Dear students, like the words for and of, at is also incorrectly omitted in some cases. For example, you should knock the door before entering. Here, we have forgotten to insert at after the verb knock. So that's why the sentence is wrong at right now. If we will insert at after the verb knock, the sentence will become correct. You should knock at the door before entering. Now we will discuss about to. Omission of to. As you know that we have already discussed about incorrect omission of at. Now we are going to discuss about incorrect omission of to. For example, you should reply her letter. Here we have incorrectly omitted the word to. That's why the sentence is wrong right now. If we insert to just after the verb, the sentence will become different cases in which we forget to use words like for, at, of, and to. These were the explanations for those incorrect omissions. I hope you all have understood that how we use and where are the places where we use these words. And that's all for today, dear students. Thank you and have a good day.